Many of the tools of the steelmaker's trade are themselves cast in steel. Immense housings for rolling mills. The rolls themselves. Automatic couplers. In the open hearth melting shop, the pans which feed scrap to the furnaces are made of steel castings. When the pans have been emptied into the furnace, the cars are pushed along the charging stage to make up a train for drawing away to the scrap bay. A furnace is tapped. The steel runs into a refractory lined ladle. When this is filled, slag from the furnace flows into another ladle where it may remain for several hours before being tipped over the slag bank. Only a cast steel ladle can withstand such treatment. The steel is then poured into molds, and from here the ingots go to the universal slabbing mill. These castings are made at the Grimesthorpe Foundry of English Steel Castings Corporation. This is virtually the birth of a heavy casting. Sand is being rammed around the wooden pattern which corresponds to the shape of the housing. A highly refractory material called compo is rammed against the actual face of the pattern to a thickness of about 3 inches. In another pit, ramming has been completed and the pattern has been withdrawn. All surfaces of the mould which will come into contact with the liquid steel need special attention. A sealing coat of refractory paste is worked into the coarse face of the compo. Meanwhile, the cores which will form the internal shape of the casting are being prepared. A cylindrical core calls for great skill on the part of the core maker. In the molding bay, the cores are being positioned. This core will form the cavity for the screw-down mechanism which adjusts the rolls in the mill. Such a large casting takes the capacity of 3 acid open hearth furnaces. This synchronization requires coordination of the highest order, from the charging of the furnaces to the pouring of the steel into the mould. In the fettling shop, a housing is almost finished. After fettling and heat treatment, the castings go to the machine shops. Turning a roll is quite straightforward, providing you have a big enough lathe. However, the more complicated the casting, the more complicated is the machining. Forgings made under this press weigh up to 160 tons and need special vehicles to take them to the machine shops. Such are the means by which the foundryman meets the ever-increasing demands of the steelmaker.